In this video, we're building a 1,400-foot road through completely undeveloped land, and it's going to lead to a house that doesn't even exist yet. To build this road, we're gonna need to cut down hundreds of trees and move 3,000 yards of material in and out of this site, all while using explosives to break up the rock and ledge. We are on an 11-acre site, and it's a raw lot, meaning that nothing was ever here. So there's a lot of things to consider when building a house in the middle of the woods. All the utilities that you need to get from the street all the way to the site. Let's start with the fact that this right here is our water line. So typically you're seeing a 1, maybe a 2-inch copper line from the street to your house. Not here. This is a ductile iron water line. This is what you typically see in a roadway. And there's 1,400 feet of this. Yes, 1,400 feet. And they're all straight sections, and they're gonna go from the street all the way back to the house. So part of early design process, we're working with a civil engineer and working through what that looks like and how it gets installed. Because that stuff's straight, and our roadway, despite what you can see right now, takes a bunch of twists and turns. So there's a lot of consideration on how that's engineered. And in here in Massachusetts, we have to make sure that that water line is well below frost, which is 4 feet for us. So the roadway that you see right here took a lot to get to this point, and we're just gonna come back and actually excavate the center of it and put that water line in. So as we walk through, you're probably looking behind me and seeing what looks like a bunch of old used tires up on a hillside. That's exactly what they are. Those are blasting mats. So we do have some blasting on this site. We have ups and downs in the roadway. We had some challenging grade to combat. And what we did is we actually worked with our site team, and they came in here and selectively blasted certain areas to make sure that we had an appropriate road. I don't even want to call it a driveway, because that's not what it is. It's actually a roadway. And the consideration that we had to make is the fact that, being that we're so far into the woods, we had to make sure that it was safe for the fire department. A fire engine has to get all the way back here in order to service an emergency, which is also why we're using a 6-inch water line. You're probably thinking, well, that seems ridiculous. That's a large water line. Why do you need something so large? We're actually gonna be installing a fire hydrant all the way back at the house, because it's too far to run from the street. So we're at the crest of the first hill here. And this is a section that we had to blast in order to get our driveway through this area. And what they're gonna do, what they've done is actually drilled, blasted this zone, and now what you're seeing is compacted gravel. A lot of this is processed material that they're bringing in, they're trucking in. Like I said, they're gonna excavate the center section here to make sure that we can get the water line installed. We're actually working through the electrical considerations, whether we bury it or run it through the woods on telephone poles. Obviously, there's benefits to both. It's more costly to do it under the road. It's less costly to go through the woods, but you have to take into consideration things like tree limbs and branches, and just simply getting a telephone pole into the woods and a drill to make sure that you can get that into the ground. As we walk our way down, you're seeing all of this rubble on the right side here. You're seeing more water line, and you're starting to see the cut that we made through this hill up here. So one of the things that makes it challenging when you're dealing with a site that does have blasting and rock is getting rid of that material. So part of what we're doing is getting all of that rock off site. And then what the trucks are essentially doing is they're taking the rock out of here and coming back with the processed gravel for our road base. Speaking of road, we're not gonna pave this. This is a house, this is a home in the middle of the woods. We don't want an asphalt driveway. We want something that is a little bit more natural. So what you're seeing here is, while it's a rough grade, the final product is going to be a compacted gravel. I got machinery behind me, so we're gonna wait for them to give us the okay. We're gonna go around, and we're gonna get to some of the more intricate details of this road. Thank you. You can imagine you're seeing a bunch of trees and vegetation around here. We had to get in here and do what we call land clearing. So we actually worked with a land clearing company, and they come in with big heavy machinery, and they're getting all of the trees out of here. And that's something that they make very quick work of. We get rid of the logs. We're basically giving a clear path to start the site work. We didn't want to just come in here and clear the whole space. We made the road as narrow as we could. The intent was not to have a massive roadway, but one that that satisfied the fire department requirements. But before that, some of the things that we ran into is wetlands. And wetlands is something that we deal with on a lot of our properties. There's protected wetlands. There's a lot of considerations and a lot of tape that we have to go through to make sure that we're satisfying a conservation committee. We had some areas that we were impacting, so working closely with them, they were able to kind of guide us in the proper way to do that. For example, we actually dealt with an area right here that was within the wetland zone that we were able to replicate in another area that's just over the crest of this hill here. By impacting one area, we actually replaced it and replicated it in another area to satisfy that. The more challenging one, as I trip backwards, the more challenging one is when you're crossing a road over that space. So we're gonna go around this machine up here and you're gonna see a culvert that we installed. All of this is a process with our civil team and working really closely with, thank you, the committees such as the Conservation Committee and of course the town. We're starting to get back down to what is kind of a level area. And this is what I would say is like the low point. As we come around, you see the loader up in front of me. He's turning around. But this area used to be a lot lower and it had this really steep incline. And if you can see way in the distance, our home site is actually at the top of that hill. But in order to get there, we had this really low point, which was all wetlands. And depending on the time of the season, it was either, sometimes it wasn't wet at all and there was no water. Right now there is actually water flowing through it. But let's talk about the design of this. So the civil engineer actually originally designed something that is cast in place concrete, which going through the pricing exercise was very expensive. We went back and forth quite a bit and weren't unable to really have a better solution until the architect actually mentioned, what if we used corrugated pipe? Now, corrugated pipe is something that you oftentimes see passing underneath a roadway to allow water to flow through. Talk about a little bit about clear space. I'm not a professional in the wetland science or any of that, but it is something that we've learned quite a bit going through this process. And essentially the clear space is designed for animal crossing. You have to design it in a way that allows for animals to clearly cross and not feel what we'll say claustrophobic or have to go up and over the roadway. We're disturbing the wetlands, we're disturbing their natural habitat. So we want it to be something that is large enough. Now, when you look at what a typical corrugated pipe would be, it would have to be much, much higher because this would be ultimately round. What looks like a squished piece of round pipe is more or less a squished piece of round pipe, but this was bent to our specification and gives us the clear space that we need and is done so without the need for cast in place concrete. Now, if you're paying attention, you might be wondering, how are we gonna get the water line over the top of the culvert, because we don't have 4 feet of protection, especially against frost. So this is where in the design and in the civil design, water line actually comes down and crosses down real low here underneath where we are, 4 feet below, but protected by frost, and then comes back up and into the roadway. We're gonna keep walking up to the top of this roadway. So I'm making my way up, culvert's behind us, and this is some of that processed gravel that they're bringing in to build our road base layer. But as you come up here, you're starting to see what is the remnants of the blasting and some of the excavation, a lot more raw looking. You have some larger rock here, smaller rocks down here, pieces of granite. And as I walk my way over here, you're gonna start to see this big hole that I was mentioning. What looks like a swimming pool is just essentially what is the remnants of deep excavation, a little bit of blasting, and preparation for a water line. So we need to make sure that as we're prepping the ground, we're giving ourselves enough depth to have a frost protected line. Again, that 6-inch ductile iron has to come all the way down this road, all the way to this location, and right to the fire hydrant. At that point, we will switch to a smaller diameter copper and run to the house. Speaking of the house, we'll get up here and I'll talk to you a little bit about where that location of the house is. So all of that roadway, 1400 feet to get to this location. And as I'm walking in this lower zone here, You might not totally understand what the appeal is, but as I crest the top of this little mound, which is roughly my finished floor elevation of the home, I get this beautiful view of the pond. So two years ago, we walked this site, no site work was done, and we determined that this is where the home was gonna be situated. You see the pond in the distance. You have this rolling hill down to a walking path, and essentially you have this really nice, what doesn't look flat right now, but eventually will be, flat site for a beautiful home designed by Of Possible. In a future episode, we'll talk about the architectural design of the home, the materials that we're using on this home. I mentioned in the beginning of the video that it's one of the most unique homes that we've ever built, and you're gonna wanna stay tuned to see that. If you're looking to build, fill out the form below, schedule a 15-minute call, and let's build your dream home.